You know that feeling when you've made a purchase and you've just added to your collection of shoes or a collection of jeans or something like that? I used to be one of those people who found excitement in having more and a lot of things. I used to love having a collection of shoes, having options. My excuse was I want to have a lot of options when I wake up in the morning. I want to choose between different types of skirts. I want to choose between different types of shoes. I just want options in my life. Eventually, I got tired. At the beginning of the year, I felt like I was being drained and weighed down by a lot of things. I felt like I had a lot of responsibilities. And this is just to say that we buy a lot of things and we bring them into our homes without actually thinking about the responsibility of taking care of those things or how they actually take up space in your mind. I was such an anxious wreck, and I used to think that, oh, it's just my mind playing games with me, until I realized that I own a lot of things. At the beginning of the year, I went and I did a massive decluttering, which consisted of me getting rid of almost 80% of my clothes, which was so liberating. I remember the first day I was texting every single person that I knew at that point in time that I've just gotten rid of my clothes. My cupboard is empty. Also, another thing, my cupboard was full. My clothes would stay in a suitcase and some would be in the cupboard. They'd be so full, there would be literally no space for more clothes, and I still kept on getting more because I wanted to be that girl traveling with a lot of suitcases and all these weird desires that I had that actually, when I think of it right now, they just had no meaning in my life. And I feel like for me personally, those desires were perpetuated by pop culture more than anything. When it comes to decluttering and getting rid of things, the most difficult thing for a lot of people, including myself, is getting rid of gifts. So there's this book called Soulful Simplicity by Courtney Carvey that I read, where she talks about the intention of a gift. Because we think that if someone buys you a pair of shoes, that's the gift. Whereas it's the intention behind the gift that's the gift. The intention, the love that comes with the gift, that's the gift. You can always get rid of the physical form of the gift and keep the love. Because she says that when you're meeting someone and you're telling them about an experience or about something, you don't say to them, come to my house, I want to show you these beautiful pair of shoes that my friend gave to me on my birthday. But what you do tell them about is the experience, the love that you experience through that gift. And she says that that is the gift. It was important for me to learn that when I was decluttering my space and getting rid of things that I didn't need anymore, things that were taking up space in my life. So it was easy for me to just accept the gift, the love that came with the gift, and let it go with love to another person. Because also the truth is, as much as I owned a lot of pair of shoes, I didn't wear all of them, and some of them hadn't been worn for 2 years. Some clothes hadn't been worn for 3 years because I was like, this is too expensive, I can't wear it every single day. That was my excuse. And I always think of it this way, like, imagine going to a party where you're a stranger but you go there with a friend, and then your friend is entertaining other people and you're not being entertained. Do you understand like how you're feeling at that point in time? So I started thinking of my clothes in that sense. Like every single time when I have to pick an outfit for the day, I'm always rejecting the other clothes. They might not be feeling comfortable with that, like being rejected. So I figured that someone else might love these clothes more than I actually love them. I realized that the thing with having a lot of clothes, having a lot of options, is just that I loved the idea of it, whereas I honestly just couldn't handle it. And the best part about decluttering is when you have to give to people. I'll just make an example of something that happened to me. I declutter every single time when I feel like there's just something heavy. So the one time when I was decluttering and I took my things out, because I usually put them outside and people take them, and luckily for me, I bumped into someone who was so excited to take my stuff. He was so happy. He literally said, I can't wait to give this to my girlfriend and my daughter. And I realized that that's the intention behind putting my things there, behind letting go of my things, because someone else will appreciate them more than I do. Because I don't think having things sitting in my cupboard, my suitcase, is actually appreciating them, is actually enjoying them. Now, moving forward, ever since I decided to be a minimalist, I've become so intentional about things that I bring into my home. Because also another thing is, ever since I decluttered things, I don't really have to take care of much. My washing is a lot less. I don't have to think twice about what I need to wear during the day or when I'm going to specific events. I don't feel the pressure to always get a new outfit every single time. I don't feel that thing of, people have seen this so I can't wear it again. I've literally divorced that idea because it's really unrealistic and unsustainable for me, at least. So now, since I spend less time doing my washing, I have more time to do other things. Because this is a question that I usually get: how do you make time to work out? How do you make time to do all the things that you do? I don't have much to do. Cleaning is literally not that much. Cooking is not that much. Cooking is probably that much sometimes, but there are things that don't take up much of my time anymore because I don't really have much to take care of. It's also with my plants. I was so intentional about the plants that I bring into my place. I didn't want plants that are going to require a lot of admin, and I also didn't want to have like a greenhouse. I just wanted to keep it minimal and for the plants to serve their purpose in my space. I've realized that it's not everything that I own that brings me joy, that sparks joy, but ever since I decluttered, every single piece of clothing, every single piece of cosmetic, everything that I own is so intentional, and it just brings me so much peace and so much joy. I can literally look at my clothes and I'm just like, wow, I've got a lot. I don't feel like I'm lacking anything ever since I got rid of it. Like, I haven't actually bought new clothes in a long time. And that just brings me to my next point, which is my minimalistic choice has impacted other people. When you come from a family of maximalists, where buying things is a way of showing you that they love you and stuff like that, I've had to gracefully reject offers because at the same time I don't want to always be decluttering, because that does take time. But at the same time, I have to always affirm and confirm with other people that it's okay, I do have enough, I do not need more, I don't have space for more. That is just to allude to my next point, which is being a minimalist has helped me so much with stopping this thing of attaching my happiness to things. I know the feeling is there when you're buying something new and you go crazy, you scream and stuff like that. But that feeling is temporary, because happiness is also just a whole different type of game. Happiness is also something else, and I would recommend that you read The Courage to be Disliked to understand what happiness is. It has everything to do with you. And it has also affected my relationships with people and the way I live my life, because now I've got like an empty space. I can think properly. I can meditate. I can hear properly, you know? And it's also made my relationships so, so meaningful. I'm so intentional about everything. That's why I have an issue with parasocial relationships, because I always question their meaning, you know? But I also appreciate them, but I'm just talking about my relationships with my friends, my family. I appreciate them more. The friends that I have, I'm very grateful for them. And this is coming from someone who wanted like to be part of a squad. I used to jump from squad to squad in high school and university because I just wanted to belong in a squad. And eventually now, I just have 3 friends, which I'm so grateful for. And I don't feel like I'm lonely or anything like that. The most important thing about minimalism for me is that it has taught me the principles of minimalism, and you can apply them anywhere. It's all about quality over quantity, and it's honestly made my life so much easier. My type of minimalism is different from your type of minimalism or any other type of minimalism. I know that it's aesthetically pleasing, it's cute, the pictures are clean, and that's also another reason why I started, because of that. But when I started realizing the mental health benefits of actually just decluttering and getting rid of things and owning less, I got attached to it. I wanted to implement the fundamental principles of minimalism in my entire life, and I honestly do not regret it, because it just makes sense. It makes life so much easier, so much more meaningful, and you just appreciate every single thing that you have, every single person in your life. As much as it may seem like I don't have much to other people, but I feel very fulfilled. I don't feel like I need more all the time. I don't feel like I need to buy, I need to purchase, I need to do this. I feel stable. which is a very good feeling considering the fact that when you're anxious, when you're an anxious person, you're always scared about the future. You're always scared of not being safe in the future. And for me, feeling stable and feeling safe in the now has been a very important factor in my life, which I am really, really grateful for. So even if you're not a minimalist in the sense of getting rid of things and whatnot, I would really highly recommend that you look at the principles of minimalism and try to apply them in relationships or wherever. It's honestly not about living in an empty house and having clean spaces. It's about more than that, and it's different for everyone. So I would highly recommend that you do check it out and listen to podcasts about it and just, you know, immerse yourself in the process. If you don't like it, it's okay. It's okay to reject it. You don't have to adopt every single thing that you see on the internet that doesn't resonate with you. That has been me talking about minimalism, how it changed my life. I hope that this video did add some value into your life. And I do hope that you have an amazing morning, amazing day, amazing night, whenever it is that you're watching this video. Thank you so much for the love and the support. I am truly grateful for it. Thank you so much for watching my video until the end. I will see you guys in my next video. I love you guys so much. Don't forget to be anything that you want to be.